Guys, do you want a free tractor? I know it sounds like a cheesy tagline, but if you have a bit of entrepreneurial spirit, I'm telling you, you could have yourself a free tractor before too long. I'm gonna show you, if you have just a couple hours to spare every week or on the weekend, not only can you get that tractor for free, but you'll have spare money to put in your pocket. I don't get to talk about it often, but I love business-related topics. Obviously, I'm a small businessman myself, and I wanna share this information with you because maybe you can look at things in a different perspective and find a way to justify that new tractor. It's hard to justify purchases like a home, a vehicle, maybe a boat. You view them as liabilities, right? They're not making you money, but you got a payment going out every month. You got the repairs, you know, the utilities, insurance, all those other costs that are just going out. What's coming in to offset those costs that are going out? Yes, you're getting equity over time. However, boats and cars, you know, typically they're gonna depreciate pretty good. Houses will appreciate at a very slow rate, and you know as well as I do that's going to ebb and flow over time, and you have a lot of repairs and upkeep, huge expenses that can come up. However, with a tractor, it's much easier to build a business case for it versus a car, a boat, or even a house. So in this video, I want to show you how to save money and make money and get your tractor for free. Hey, and if you like what you see here, I'd love to get a thumbs up from you. And if you want to hit that subscribe button right down below, I would really appreciate it. And read through that description below as well. All sorts of helpful links right down there for cool tractor products, or head on over to goodworkstractors.com. The first thing I want to talk about is price. What's the total amount you have to invest in order to get that tractor for free? Now, you could do this with any array of attachments, any model. The sky's the limit. For this example here, I'm going to choose a 1025R equipped with a front-end loader, with a belly mower, and with a backhoe. I'm using round numbers here. I'm using new equipment pricing as well. I'm not taking into consideration interest rates or other fees that may go along with it. I really just want simple math. There's no need to overthink it. Once you kind of get that rough estimate of what you're working with, it's okay at that point to kind of go through the nitty-gritty and fine-tune it. So I'll put the individual attachment breakout and everything right down below in the description of the video. But $40,000, that's the round number for brand new pricing. I've gone a little bit on the high side as well, just because I know numbers fluctuate all over the country and I don't want anybody thinking this is unrealistic. So $40,000, what's that gonna get you? So for that $40,000, that's going to include a brand new 1025R with a front end loader and a bucket, a mid-mount belly mower, 60 inches, and a backhoe as well. Also, you're gonna get a bagger, a very nice bagger system, a snow pusher, a rototiller, a brush hog or rotary cutter, a stump grinder, and then a trailer to pull those attachments along with you. So I picked a variety of attachments for year-round use, you know, spring, summer, fall, winter, something to keep you busy all year round. Okay, so if you wanna get a free tractor and have somebody else pay you for your own tractor, here's what you need to do. You need to figure out what your annual cost is gonna be to own the tractor and all the attachments, and then figure out how much money you need to make to offset that cost. And now I know I said I'm only gonna go based on new, but I did actually take the time to calculate the used cost as well. So if you're gonna go in new and have $40,000 invested in the entire setup, you're gonna look at about $666 a month, or a round number, $8,000 a year that you're gonna have to pay for your tractor and attachments. But if, and that's a big if, let's just say 75% of that value, so 25% cheaper, you can get everything used. You know, a nice tractor loader backhoe, you find some nice attachments, you're able to finance it all without any cash out of pocket if you want to go that route. So you're going to have $30,000 overall invested. I did factor in a 5% interest rate on the used $30,000 package though, just because you can't finance used tractors for 0%. But that's going to bring you down to $570 a month, or about $6,800. So $1,200 less that you need to make a year in order to get your tractor for free. So I know that may seem like a whole lot of cash, and it is, but if you have just a couple hours a week to spend in your spare time, the weekends, the evenings, a couple hours a week, not only will you get your tractor for free, but you'll have money left over, put it right back in your pocket. All right, guys, so I did a lot of thinking about this. You know, I am, I guess, a serial entrepreneur. You know, I have started quite a few businesses. I've made a lot of business plans that never went anywhere, but I just enjoy thinking about this type of a topic. So I hope you find it helpful. And again, read down below in the description. I will put a recap of all of this information down there and just plug and play the different attachments. You know, it doesn't need to be this setup. I'm just showing you this is totally feasible and doable. And if I can do it, so can you. Okay, so these six or seven different tasks right here total up to almost $11,000 in annual revenue or annual sales that you can generate. So first, trenching, using your backhoe, all right? One of the funnest things you can do with your tractor, you can get a pretty good rate for that, about 150 bucks an hour. If you just do 15 hours worth of work with your backhoe, that's gonna generate 2,250 bucks a year. Now let's talk about a bagging system, whether it's a material collection system, a pull behind, could be a PTO driven, a lot of options out there, but spring and fall cleanups are very popular. You need to have it done if you live, especially in the northern half of the US. They're one of the pricier attachments to get, so not as much competition out there. You can charge a little bit more for them as well. So I took an average of about $130 for cleaning up a yard in the fall. 10 different yards, let's say you do it twice in the fall. You don't wait for all the leaves at once, you do it partway through and then you come back at the end and do it again. So 10 yards, doing that twice a year is gonna get you $2,600 bucks in revenue. Okay, now let's talk about a snow pusher. It could be a snow plow or a snow blower. Your cost is gonna vary though if you swing away from this, but with a snow pusher, let's say you get 20 bucks a driveway, you have 10 driveways that you're doing, say in a neighborhood or a fairly consolidated area, you do it 10 times a winter, that's gonna bring in about $2,000 in revenue. Now one of my favorite springtime tasks, tilling gardens. I love to do it. I don't do it for less than 100 bucks, and in fact, the last time that I did it when I had free time, I was doing 125 bucks even for a garden, but let's just say $100, you have 10 gardens that you can do. You can get that done on one Saturday in the spring, you know, very easy to do. That's gonna bring in $1,000 right there. Another really enjoyable job, using your brush hog or your rotary cutter, just making a field look like new, just all fresh, getting it mowed down. This is one of those tasks where, well, and a lot of these are really, where you can get repeat clients. You know, brush hogging, you typically need to do it a couple times a year, maybe three times a year even. So brush hogging is typically a little bit longer project. So I said 150 bucks times 10 different fields or 10 different customers, you know, over the course of the year. Maybe it's only five customers and you're doing it twice. Either way, let's say 1,500 bucks for that. Okay, so the last example here is a stump grinder. That's what I included. Honestly, I don't exactly know what you can charge for a stump grinder. So I Googled it and it said roughly $200 an hour. So I'm using 150 bucks an hour in this example for, you know, renting somebody with a stump grinder. So if you can stay busy for 10 hours at 150 bucks an hour throughout the course of the year, that's gonna generate another 1,500 bucks. Okay, so this list did not include using your front end loader, mowing, using your trailer to haul stuff for other folks. The list just goes on, all sorts of creative ways to make money with your machine. It's just to provide an example. And you're gonna find, because with any new business, any new venture, there's gonna be certain services that are gonna be more in demand that you're gonna be able to charge a premium for. And maybe your market is flooded with people with tillers, you know, and there's just so much competition where you either have to lower your price so much where it doesn't make it worth it, or you're just not gonna get a lot of business. So you kinda gotta do a little homework, and it's just an evolution. It changes over time. You're gonna find certain types of work that you just really enjoy doing. For me, I love tilling gardens. I love brush hogging fields. I love snow pushing. I guess I just like to sit on a tractor. And so you could fall into that category as well, where you just want that seat time because it's enjoyable, it's stress relief, and if you can make some money doing it, pay off your tractor in the meantime, then why not look into it? Quickly, I do wanna mention a few maybe obvious costs that you wanna consider, but wear and tear, maintenance, fuel cost, insurance costs. These are gonna be, you know, small things overall, but they will add up with time. So you can either build those into your bid prices, you know, your hourly rate, or just find some other way to manage it and know that you kind of have to almost peanut butter spread those costs over the week or over the month or over the year. Okay, so let's talk numbers again. About $11,000 in annual revenue or annual sales that you're bringing in just in a couple hours a week. And again, keep in mind, that's paying for more than just the cost of having your machine and the attachments. If we go back to the new and the used pricing examples, we had $8,000 a year, the cost for the new, everything new, and then we had about $6,800 on the cost for everything used. So it's simple math, right? 11,000 minus 8,000 leaves you with a $3,000 surplus or money in your pocket. $11,000 minus $6,800, 4,200 bucks left over. So one important point, folks don't care if you have new or used equipment, as long as it looks nice, right? As long as you're not riding up in a jalopy and things are falling apart in their yard while you're trying to get their work done that they're paying you for. So the closer you can be to zero, in my opinion, the better off you're gonna be. So if you have less debt to pay off, and you can still get the job done effectively, you can still charge the same amount for those projects, then you're gonna be that much closer to paying it off and making money a lot quicker. Oh, but really quick, in those examples I gave, That was a 5-year payoff on the $40,000 and the $30,000. So with this surplus that you generate, working just a couple hours a week, you could potentially pay off, if you put all the surplus funds towards paying off the tractor, you could pay it off in 3 years instead of 5 years. So I wanna share a few tips with you to help shorten that learning curve and make you more successful right out of the gate. So first of all, you need to buy the tractor that meets your needs, that comes with the attachments that you need to get your jobs done at home. I mean, after all, that's why you're getting one in the first place, to save money from hiring out the work to other contractors, get it done when you want it done instead of being on their wait list for months to come. And instead of just paying for services, you can pay for a tangible asset that you can have value in after you're all done. But once you have that tractor, getting other attachments isn't nearly as large of an investment as the tractor was to begin with. You know, a grapple is a couple grand versus, you know, 20 or 25 grand for the tractor itself. So you can add on those other attachments, even if they're not something you may use around your house. If you can build a business case for it, then it's an easy way to add on that attachment and give you more ability to service customers year round. So two pieces of advice about pricing, because that's a big question mark that sometimes you can fret over. What am I gonna advertise? What am I gonna tell somebody this is gonna cost on a per hour or per project basis? Number one, don't be afraid to adjust your pricing. What's today's price might not be tomorrow's price. You know, if nobody's calling you or emailing you or texting you with quote requests, then guess what? Your pricing is probably too high. So feel free to lower it down. But on the flip side, you may get to a point where your backlog is so long that you don't even wanna take on any more work. And if that's the case, you've got the opposite problem. You are not charging enough. That either means that you're doing such high quality work and you have such a great reputation that folks just want to keep coming to you, or you're just a lot cheaper than the competition. And number two, to go along with that, you only have so much time. That is your most valuable resource. I fight and struggle with it every day. I try to get as much done as I can, but at the end of the day, time's up. So put your efforts where you can make the most money or where you can enjoy your time the most with the limited amount of hours that you have every week. But if you've already committed to doing projects that are earning you $100 an hour, and people are calling saying, hey, I need you to do this more expensive type of project that's 150 or maybe $200 an hour, well, you see where I'm going, right? You need to minimize those cheaper projects and take the more expensive ones to get your return a lot quicker. So really, there's some big benefits here besides just getting your tractor for free, right? A lot of us want a tractor to get our work done. That is the number one reason we're gonna get it. You can typically get it done a lot cheaper if you have a lot of projects or year-round work at your house or your homestead. But this is also a grown-up toy, right? This is stress relief. This is playtime. It's fun. It's a hobby. This is how we want to spend our free time, you know, sitting on a tractor, out in the fresh air, in the woods, in the field, just around the house, outside having fun. But with the right mindset and a little bit of perseverance and a couple hours a week, not only can you have fun on your tractor, get your jobs done around the house, you can borrow that money from the bank and have somebody else pay for it. But what do you have at the end? Well, you have a tractor, attachments, paid off tools that are ready to make you money for years to come. So if you enjoyed this video, I'd love to get a thumbs up from you, and make sure you hit that subscribe button right down below. And as always, if you're in the market for a tractor or attachment, read through the description underneath the video, links to all sorts of cool tractor products, or head on over to goodworkstractors.com. Thanks so much for taking the time to stop by. Until next time, stay safe. We'll see you soon.